Hi friends, welcome back to Best Ready Study. In this video, we are going to see all the details regarding TCS NQT 2020 exam. We are going to discuss the registration process, updated exam dates, syllabus, and also important instructions to the candidates who are going to attend this exam. And also we are going to see the updated syllabus as well as the guest paper for TCS NQT 2020. So stay tuned to this video till the end to get the useful information. So now let's begin the video. So coming to the TCS, every year TCS will conduct this NQT exam. So this year it is conducting for the students who are going to pass out next year, that is now in 2019 it is conducting the exam for the students who are going to pass out in 2020. So this is the greatest opportunity for all the students who are going to pass out next year, that is 2020. So now let's see first of all how to register for this particular exam, because this registration process is going to end within few days. So now let's see how to register successfully for TCS NQT 2020 exam. So first of all, what you need to do is you have to go to the official website with the name TCS NQT. Okay, the link is www.careers.tcs.com. So once you go to that website, there will be a new page opening. In that you can see all the dates, updated exam dates of TCS NQT 2020. So the registration has already began in 2019 June itself, and the end date, the last date for registration of TCS NQT 2020 is 24th July. So after 24th July, they are not going to accept any registrations or applications. So if you are interested to write this exam, and if you are the student who are going to pass out next year, that is in 2020, happily register or not before 24th of July 2019, and hall ticket will be issued on 31st of July 2019, and exam dates are changed. So listen carefully, exam dates are changed. The online test is going to be conducted on 3rd and 4th of August 2019, and the students who are successfully qualified in this particular online test, then only those students will be having the online interview or the offline interview, which will be on 9th August 2019 onwards. So if you wanted to attend to the interview, you should be passing the cutoff of the online exam, then only you will be called to the interview. So after going to this particular page, you can see the link with the name register now. Click on the register now, and after clicking on the register now, a new page will be opened, and there you can follow all the steps one by one and happily register successfully on or before 24th of this month. Okay, so after clicking on the register now, you have to select whether you are IT or BPS. Okay, BPS means business process services. If you are IT, click on IT, else click on BPS. Okay, so after that, a new page will be opening. There you need to enter your name, date of birth, gender, email ID, mobile number, institute name, qualification, year of passing of your education, and what is your nearest test location, means where you wanted to write the exam and which is your nearest location, and enter your password, the password which have to fulfill all the criteria. Okay, there will be, after enter password, you can see the star. As per TCS password policy, click on that, then they will show you the details like your password, what all things your password should consist of. Okay, so happily give the password, and you have to re-enter the password, then select the security question, and they'll give you a character. So you have to see the character and enter as it is. After that, click on submit. Here means you have already submitted. After submitting, it means that you are going to the next step. Okay, till the last step, happily register each and every detail which they ask you. After registration is successful, you are applicable for writing this exam. Okay, so now let's see what are the few more details which I can tell you and I can help you. So the same website, which is the official website which I told, tcscareers.com. So there, if you go to the little down of the page, there you can see the test pattern for TCS National Qualifier Test. Okay, so in this particular exam, you will be having four different sections. You're having the section of English, quantitative aptitude, programming, MCQ questions, and coding. Okay, there will be four different sections. And coming to English, you will be having 15 questions, 15 questions. And coming to aptitude, that is quantitative aptitude, 15 questions, 15. And coming to the programming MCQs, you'll be asked only 10 questions. And at last, there will be one coding question where you have to write it, write the complete program, and then you need to get the output. Okay. So for English, they will give you 10 minutes. And for aptitude, they'll give you 30 minutes. For logical, that is programming logic, they are going to give you 20 minutes. And for coding one program, they are going to give you 30 minutes. So totally there are 90 minutes for your particular exam. And if you have any queries, you can go to the bottom of the page. There you can see the FAQs. After clicking on those, each and every FAQ, whatever question you have, then they'll provide you the answer for that. You can happily go through all the questions. Now let's see what is the criteria, okay, eligibility criteria for registration of this particular exam. So coming to the criteria, you should be year like 2020 year pass out. Okay, if it is graduation, you should pass out in 2020. If it is PG, also same, you have to pass out. You should be the pass out candidate of year 2020. And coming to the qualification, you should be either BE, BTech, ME, MTech, MSc or MCA. Okay, if you are any of the student which who follows this category, like if you are either BTech, BE, ME, MTech, MSc or MCA, then you are eligible for this particular exam. And coming to the engineering streams, all the students, like all the engineering streams of UG or PG, are eligible. And at least you should have 60% in from 10th to the highest qualification. Okay, if you are UG, you should have at least 60% from 10th inter and UG. If you are PG, plus PG. Okay, so for every particular stream from 10th to PG, you should have, you must have 60% criteria. Okay, at least 60% you should have in order to register. And coming to backlogs, if you have one backlog, it's fine. If you have more than one backlog, they are not going to allow you. And if you have gap, like, you know, educational gap between year to year, like if you have 2 years gap, it's fine. If you have more than 2 years gap, then you are not eligible to apply for this particular exam. Maximum they are allowing only 2 years gap between your education. So if you are having more than 2 years, it's better not to register because you are not applicable. And coming to the few more details, now let's see what is the syllabus, updated syllabus of TCS NQT 2020 exam. So now let's see, coming to the quantitative aptitude, you are going to have 15 questions. And coming to the quantitative syllabus, the questions will be asked from number system, which is very easy, HCF, LCM, time, speed and distance, time and work, percentages, mixtures and allegations, functions, permutations and combinations, clock and calendar, geometry, algebra, average, equations, series, progressions, functions and percentages. Okay, the things which I told you, this is the updated syllabus for TCS NQT 2020 exam. I'm giving you the detailed information of each and every section. Now I just told you the detailed syllabus of quantitative aptitude. Now let's see what is the syllabus of programming language. Okay, so coming to the programming languages, you should have the complete knowledge about the basics of the programming languages such as C, C++. And coming to the C language, you're going to be asked questions on call by value, call by reference, pointers, library functions, command line arguments, user defined functions. Coming to the algorithms, you should be perfect in searching and sorting algorithms, tree, traversal, dynamic programming, etc. And coming to the normal programming concepts, you should be confident in OOPs, object oriented programming language, procedural language, recursion, iteration, arrays, etc. And coming to the data structures, be confident and be really good at basics of arrays, list, hash table, trees, queue, stacks. All this is the portion coming to the programming language. Now let's see what is the portion for English. English, it's very easy, but you need to manage your time. So coming to English, you're going to be asked questions on parajumbles, direct and indirect speech, prepositions, articles, close passage, which is one of the most important topic, close passage, and also sentence completion as well as fill in the blanks. They may also ask you spot the errors in the sentence. Okay, so coming to English particularly, you must manage your time, because time management is very important for this particular exam. And coming to the coding, there will be one coding question and you have to write the complete program and you should get the output within 30 minutes of time. There's one program and time is 30 minutes. And coming to the program, you can write the program in any language. You can write either in C, C++, Java, Perl or Python. The same program, the same output, and language is your wish. You have to select the language within any of the five languages which I told you. And coming to the instructions, there is negative marking. So please don't take the risk of guessing the answers or, you know, just blind marking. Don't do those kind of risks, because this like lakhs and lakhs of students are going to attend to this exam. So each and every mark of yours will really count in this particular exam. So please don't take the risk of guess marking and all. And next tip which I wanted to tell you is, please don't waste your time, okay? Once they have started the exam, once they have given you the official password and the username, like during exam they'll be giving you the password, after entering that code only you'll be able to start the exam. Okay, once you're ready with the everything stuff which they have given you, just start your exam. Don't waste your time, because most of the students of this particular exam will run out of the time. They know everything, but the thing is they don't have time to solve, okay, because they have to manage the time, okay, because in this particular exam they also see your time management. Okay, the greater you manage your time, the more marks you're going to get. And once you're successful in this online exam, the cutoff of this particular TCS NQT exam differs from year to year. So they don't consider your percentage, they consider your percentile. If you are crossing the cutoff based upon the percentile, then you are qualified and you will be getting a call for your interview, and there they'll be testing on your technical skills and few more skills. And now let's see what are the few more details regarding this particular exam. So coming to the coding questions, out of four sections which I told you, English and programming language, MCQ, quantitative aptitude and coding, out of these four, first you need to concentrate mostly on 30 marks, which gives you, which one program gives you, okay, like 30 minutes, sorry, not 30 marks, 30 minutes, one program, okay. And make sure you get the correct output. There comes the matter, because the output, if you are done with the correct output, you're going to get full on full marks. So concentrate firstly on your coding, and then work on English, and later concentrate on quantitative aptitude as well as the programming MCQs equally. So now let's see what are the points to be noted as instructions. Coming to the coding questions, they'll be asking you one simple question and 30 minutes time will be given. For example, let's see one question. This is the question. Given a series, like they'll give you a series, write a program to print the reverse of the series, okay. For example, the question is, they'll give you a series, okay. Example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 10, okay. They're asking you have to print the same series in reverse order. That is, the output should give, like, whatever the user enter, like the series, in reverse order, the output should come, okay. For example, as a user, I have given the input as 1 to 10, okay. The output should come from 10 to 1 in reverse order. I hope you understood the question. So such kind of simple questions you're going to get in this particular exam. So the language is your wish. You can write in C, C++, Java, Perl or Python. So based on that, just decide. I hope most of the students select C or Java, because Java is one of the language which saves a lot of time. And most of the students, I heard that they are going to attempt in the coding in C or C++. Very few try with Python or Perl. So now let's see what are the MCQ questions coming to the programming languages. They will give you a question and they will ask you, what is the output? So such kind of questions are very important. At least 4 to 5 questions of such type are going to be asked in the exam. Note this point. And I'll tell you a few questions. What are the elements present in the array of the following code? Options they'll give you, like they'll give int array of 5 is equal to 5 in flower brace, okay. I'm repeating the question. What are the elements present in the array of the following code? Int array 5 is equal to 5, okay. See this particular question and the options, use logical thinking, and you need to solve very quickly by managing your time. And few other questions are, local variables are stored in an area which is called dash, okay. I'm repeating the question. Local variables are stored in an area. That area, what is the area called? Options are heap, stack, free memory, permanent storage area. Correct answer is stack. Okay, that area is called stack. So such kind of simple questions will be asked, and few questions will be asked like, guess the output. They'll give you the program. What is the output? Okay. Options are compilation error, runtime error, all those kind of options you'll be getting, which will be few logical, like questions, few will be very logical, few will be very easy and direct. So it's you who need to manage your time since your first question to the last. So that's it for today. And the main information, the main point which I wanted to tell you is, in coming up videos, I'm going to do the you know, the instructions and the tips for each and every particular topic of each and every particular section. I'm going to give you tips for quantitative aptitude, coding and English, as well as your programming MCQs. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such wonderful videos, and like and share this video with all your friends to help them to get the job in TCS and NQT. So all the very best for all the students who are going to attend this exam. Thanks for watching this video.